Hello, my name is Igor Bahor. I'm a potter. I will present today my research on thin layer of clay, terra sigillata. In this paper, I will present cooperation between scientists Dr. Milko, Novič and me. We are coming from Pottery Center Bahor from Slovenia, and I am proud to say that we solved the question. My presentation is focused on the last 5 month procedure. Ancient Roman potters were well known as producers of exceptionally pottery, on which their terra sigillata undoubtedly stands out. Today, it is easy to talk about how to make this incredible thin layer of clay and provide it with the properties that make it appear as it had been glazed. But how did this smart technology work in Roman times? In my research, I tried to get to the root of this question. How did this ingenious technology work in ancient Roman times? In this paper, I'd like to present this absolutely superlative experimental journey. I'm going to start by providing a bit of background, previous investigations about the terra sigillata. Not counting the times I needed to make this coating for artistic or decorative purposes. I made this fascinating technological procedure years ago when I was preparing workshop on terra sigillata for the students of the Department of Archaeology at the University of Ljubljana. At the time, I thoroughly revisited the procedure and tested if it can be repeated with the different types of clay. I posited that not every type of clay was suitable for making terra sigillata, and my hypothesis was confirmed. Experts at the City Museum of Ljubljana, where original terra sigillata artifacts are kept, were impressed with my forensic approach. In 2019, they invited me to head the execution of making a replica terra sigillata plate, pitcher and sauce boat. This was an opportunity to melt my 30 years of experience and inquiring spirit into an experimental archaeological product. Aside from precisely replicating the shape, I also managed to make an exceptionally beautiful coating, which was also fulfilled all the quality standards as known from expert sources. Sheen, waterproof, vitrified surface, appearance and feel. However, I used sodium silicate as deflocculant, which was unknown in ancient Roman times. This was something I couldn't stop thinking about. How this sophisticated technology actually worked in ancient Roman times. My colleague, Dr. Milko Novič and I based the plan for our study on three factors. First, archaeologically confirmed facts about the properties of the highest quality terra sigillata. Second, chemical analysis of terra sigillata, Gallic and Ruthenian. And third, 30 years of my expertise in the field of pottery archaeology. Archaeologically confirmed facts, which I am categorizing according to 5 distinguishable features, which place terra sigillata at the forefront of ancient Roman technological procedures. The color is intense red, the surface is vitrified, is waterproof, is resistant to scratches, and it doesn't not crumple when it's pressed. The break of the shards is clean and sharp. The shine is achieved without polishing. The product produces a clear sound. The sound test I will show you at the end of the presentation. Chemical analysis, which tell us potassium content was higher in the best quality terra sigillata. The thickness of the coating is approximately 30 microns, and here is a high content of flint. My experience allows me to predict that procedure had to have been smart, replicable, simple and cheap, considering quality. The modern procedure to get terra sigillata by using sodium silicate was familiar to me already. The recipe you can see on the slide, also the floating and density. Questions which I feared need to be answered in order to replicate Aretinian terra sigillata using ancient Roman technology. What to use instead of sodium silicate? How to achieve floating, separation of colloidal particles? How to measure density? In the beginning, we thought we came upon a revolutionary realization, namely that ash contains enough potassium which is missing in the basic chemical composition of the clay. We prepared the water to clay ratio as we knew it from the tried and tested recipe 70-30 with the assumption that the presence of sodium silicate was what caused floating and separation. In total of 81 fired samples, we achieve zero occurrences of sheen. In the following series of tests, we tried to cause floating using potassium extract and a different ratio. In the table below, A stands for ash, B clay, and C water. Separation of fine particles in the solution was not possible. Three problems arose. First, the suspension settled completely. Second, the suspension floated completely. Third, the suspension partly floated. Fine particles were impossible to extract by using the methods of pouring. We performed 120 tests and no gloss again. Anyway, some gloss came out on 101 sample. After this great disappointment, we had completely divergent opinions on how to proceed. We established two concepts, as you can see. First concept, terra sigillata is a glaze, a chemical composition made up of three basic components, glass making, flux, and refractory. Second concept, terra sigillata is not a glaze, it must be treated like colloidal clay coating. The key is in the procedure and the technique of separating fine clay particles. Trials from both concepts were performed. We performed a series of 10 new experiments from concept 1. From my concept, I use vinegar, honey, flax, agar, cornstarch, urine, slaked lime, calcium hydroxide, mica, seawater, and also seagrass lye, all in different rations. I performed a series of 60 new experiments. Not all was bad. Some of the experiments at a certain coating thickness, a gloss appeared. I noticed, however, that the color of the terra sigillata made with the seagrass lye was considerably more intense. At this point, science stepped out. Another big disappointment that made me think that perhaps it was not the flocculant that was the key, but rather the physical occurrences taking a place between the very small particles in the solution. This is why I also tried the dusting technique. I observed that fine particles floated for a while and that I was easy able to separate them. 3 kilo of dry clay would only produce 20 grams of terra sigillata after 48 hours of precise and time-consuming work. At this point, I started new experiments, temperature range to achieve floating. Finally, I have got the result. So the finest part of the clay tends to gloss. The deadline for submission of materials to EXARC conference was also the date on which I first succeed in achieving gloss using the separation procedure exclusively using clay and water. The first vessel, fired at a temperature of 1080 Celsius, gave me a satisfactory visual result. Still, the question of density must be solved. I am gonna use floating egg method. Here I have two different density of terra sigillata, just to show how it works. First one is too diluted, and the second one is just the right density. The egg should float about 1 centimeter above the surface. So at the end, only clay and water. The mystery is in the preparation procedure. Incredible! I would like to conclude my presentation by invitation to visit us in Canidol, within the Idria UNESCO Global Geopark, where our Center for Experimental Archaeology is settled. Also, many thanks to EXARC organizer, and big thanks to my crew, and thanks all participating institutions. For the end, I promise you the sound test also.